Hi, let us try and understand rationality, irrationality, and the conversion of irrationality into rationality. So rationality, as we try and understand, that it is the natural order of energy conservation. Our primary focus is always how to conserve energy. Now, to understand this, we need to identify these three layers of existence: physical, physiological, and psychological. And corresponding to this, we have actions, sensations, and perceptions, respectively. Let's try and understand with illustration. Suppose I touch fire. It's an action which brings some chemical change physiologically. So previously it was a physical action, and that brought some chemical change, and that brought an understanding, a perception, psychological perception, that the fire is hotter than the normal. So here what we see, a physical action brings some physiological sensation, and that physiological sensation brings some psychological perceptions, and then that psychological perceptions progressively, naturally, bring some newer physical actions, and this automation goes on and on naturally, and this doesn't need any extra energy investment from our side. This happens automatically, naturally. This leads to conservation of energy. Now, the same slide, actually we have reduced some words: physical, physiological, and psychological. So let's try and understand an actions. Not only an action, but actions bring sensations, and sensations bring perception. And perceptions helps us to get to newer actions. This is a natural, rational automation. Now, whatever the terms that we have so far discussed are physical, physiological, and psychological, corresponding to that, acting, sensations, and perceptions. Actually, actions, sensations, and perception. So actions are something which can be externally, mechanically received physically. So actions are nothing but receiving of the external information, and after that, inwardly, that is processed. So it is chemically sensed physiologically, and that sensation is perceived neurally, psychologically. That is called perception. Now, let's revisit the understanding of rationality, or the conservations of energy: actions followed by sensations, followed by perceptions, followed by repeat of the action. So here we see the examples of rational emotion leading from action to sensation, then rational thinking leading from sensation to perceptions, and further from perceptions to action is the rational creativity or rational action. Now, the irrationality will be a reverse loop. When the perceptions will bring some sensation. Earlier slide we saw sensations bring perception. Here we are seeing something opposite. So nothing is experienced physically, but from the mind side we brought some physiological sensation, and that sensation automatically again brings some perception which will approve the previous perception, and it will form a loop within itself. This is actually a trap of perceptions, and sensation. This is an example of ideated emotions or irrational emotions. Now, with this state of zapped vitality in the trap of perceptions and sensations, if we go and take some action, that action will be a low energy action, and it will be an example of emotional action or irrational action. Further, this action, since it is a low energy or sometimes stimulated energy, it will bring an excuse to our perception. It is an example of irrational thought. And further, the trap will go on and on. Now, let us look at an example of rationality. I am hungry. I have a plate full of mangoes in front of me. I eat the first one. It was extremely relishable. Then I eat the second one. It was also relishable, but little less. The next. The fifth one becomes a bit taxing for me. Sixth becomes painful. So now what happens in the diagram that we understood? I start eating when I felt hungry. This is the first condition. That's another loop we can form, but let's start our understanding from this point. Start eating when I feel hungry. So that when I start eating, that brings some chemical change physiologically within me. And I perceive that change and I identify the type of chemical change. Type of chemical change means whether it is relishable or less relishable or taxing or painful, that kind of evaluation process that happens naturally from the sensation to the perception. Now, from this identifying of the chemical change, that's the starting point for any independent act, discrete act. So that will bring, so this identification of the chemical change within will bring to the next set of action, whether to continue or stop eating another mango. And the story goes on and on. This was the example of rationality. Here we see rational emotion out of an action, rational thinking out of a sensation, and rational action out of perception. That could be termed as a rational creativity, because every action is a new action in this cycle of rationality. Let us look at an example of irrationality. I am in a party. I don't have anybody known around me. I stop looking at the available people around. I start looking at the fact of non-availability of any known person. I start sensing a loneliness. I start repenting for joining this party. My loneliness overpowers. I get frustrated. I leave the party. I start hating parties. Now, in this cycle, let us try and understand what happens. I start with a perception which proposes I should have known people to interact. I should have known people to interact. And that brings a sensation within me. Otherwise, it is boring. So, it actually make it stronger, the perception stronger further. Because of its natural progression from sensation to perception, I make it, I should have only known people to interact. And this becomes a stronger perception, and it becomes a trap of perception and sensation for me. And in this situation, we identify the aspect of ideated emotion or irrational emotion. Now further, if I take an action, which would be here, I leave the party, as explained. So this will be an emotional action or irrational action. Further, my leaving of the party will definitely bring an excuse, and that will be an irrational thought. Now the story goes on with the new perception that is formed due to the previous loop that one must leave in this condition. And that brings a sensation that parties are boring. And that again strengthen the perception, and another trap. Further example of ideated emotion, irrational emotion, and then further the action comes, I start avoiding parties. That becomes further, I hate parties. So this actually is an example of emotional action or irrational action. This will definitely bring that excuses, and I start progressively hating parties. Now, let us look at an example of irrationality converted into rationality. So the same example of the party will pick up to understand this one. I am in a party. I don't have anybody known around me. So the first two steps are same. Now, the third step is different here. Here I am converting the rationality into irrationality into rationality. I start looking at the people and start inquisitively observing them. I start getting to know a lot of new things while observing the people around. Incidentally, I speak to some of them. Few of them started speaking to me as well. I started getting more and more new information. I come back from the party enhancing my cognitive growth with my inquisition. So what happens here? Inquisition towards the available new information. Whatever the situation may be, I am inquisitive. I am perennially inquisitive towards those new information. And that brings an action. What is that action? Nothing but keen observation. And from the keen observation, I actually get some sensation. And what is that sensation? Sense of growth with the processing of the newly observed information. I repeat, sense of growth with the processing of the newly observed information. And that brings a stronger perception towards the inquisition. And the story goes on and on. So it starts with a rational action, which can also be termed as rational creativity. And that brings rational emotion, and that gets strengthened with a rational thinking. So this is one example of such kind of conversion. And I request all the people, those who are listening to this video, to bring their examples so that we can work together on bringing rationality in our lives. Thank you.